Morning, everybody. Kevin here from Watch This with Joe and Kevin, jumping to episode 6 of the second season of For All Mankind. I freaking love this show. The second season, to me, has been even more compelling than the first one because of the buildup that we're getting. Like, we didn't know a whole lot about what we were building to in the first season. The first season was great, and the finale was amazing. But I feel like we've kind of set up some storylines that we know that there's going to be some payoff coming, and there's a that creates a level of anticipation the first season didn't have. I have no notes for the first season, by the way. I'm just really stoked the idea that we have these, in terms of the space missions, we have these three completely different stories that seem to be kind of coming to a dangerous head, right? We have the moon base where Tracy is really struggling. Gordo's going to be there soon, and we've just put armed Marines on the moon. And I feel like there's, if not all the way, but really close to some type of combative situation with the Soviets is inevitable. I feel like maybe we don't get to the part where anybody's shooting anybody else, but it may get really, really close to that. I think it's going to come down to cooler heads having to prevail at some point, that we're heading that way. And I'm wondering where that plays into kind of getting muddled with the Pathfinder mission, right? And the Apollo-Soyuz mission, which seems like that would even have be a bigger complicating factor since both will involve the Soviets. Like, does one have an impact on the other? I'm really curious where that's going. Tracy and Gordo, I think in terms of personal storylines, I'm really interested in. The last episode was really great in showing how both of them are really kind of struggling to come to grips with their actual professional roles with NASA, based on where their personal lives are. And I hope it doesn't sound like I'm being sexist, but I'm finding it easier to empathize with Gordo than I am with Tracy a little bit. In season one, when their marriage is falling apart, that was all on Gordo, right? It was because he was having affairs that ultimately was the death knell in their marriage. I completely understand that, and that's totally on Gordo. This season, though, Tracy has done really well for herself, right? She's met and married, it sounds like, a really great guy. She's incredibly popular. She's a celebrity. And her struggles with being on the moon seem to have a lot to do, and I hope this isn't unfair, but it seems like it's the cushiness of her life that she's really missing. You know, she says it. She misses her bed. She misses, you know, Sam. I think that's his name. So her struggles to adapt to the moon have a lot more to do with this. Just isn't who she is anymore. She was missing training because she was too busy, you know, being on Johnny Carson and stuff like that. And so her implosion kind of. It's harder to get on board with than Gordo's. Gordo's is psychological trauma, which I feel like that's a lot easier to empathize with. And man, this isn't exactly what I've wanted it to be, or was cracked up to be, or I miss my life. For Tracy, just quit being an astronaut. They're giving they offered her an out. Take the ride up and just go home. Be done. That might have been, you know, career suicide as far as being a celebrity too, so maybe that's why she didn't really want to take it. But I certainly don't think she wants to be an astronaut anymore. Gordo is just trying to face his fears and overcome something that was completely debilitating, which I think is easier to root for. But I guess we'll see more of what that looks like as we move forward here. I cannot believe we're at this point. We're halfway through with the season already. It is flying by. I do want to go and thank all of our Patreon subscribers for being here with us. I'd like to give a special shout out to Actuarial Lurker, Balazs Foldez, Chris, Jeff, Christy Gubberston, NJ, Suya Gundavarapu, and Weird Magic. Thanks so much, guys. We're happy here with us. If you would like to see a full-length reaction to this and everything else we've watched or currently watching, please check out the link in the description below to our Patreon page. On every show, including For All Mankind, we're at least 4 episodes ahead on Patreon of where on YouTube. So if you get done watching the YouTube edits, would like to keep going, you could do it on our Patreon page. You will have to sync and watch along on your own Apple TV Plus. You're only going to see and hear me for copyright purposes. And we're also watching 30 Rock as a Patreon exclusive. Well, I was wondering, it's like, are we in the Soviet Union right now? No, we're welcome to the Soviet astronauts.
Houston.
Wait, we are in Houston.
Exciting day, isn't it? This is going to be a great mission for our two countries and for the whole world.
For Danielle, for being the one person who's genuinely excited about this.
Cosmonauts should not be referred to as astronaut
That's
three
true.
And astronaut four, as though they are afterthoughts. We would also suggest Soyuz Apollo as the name of the mission. For the sake of convenience.
The Apollo side will be the active mechanism, and the Soyuz will be passive.
The Soyuz side will be the active mechanism.
That would require a complete redesign on our part.
Yes.
Well, this guy's not being very cooperative. I mean, spoiler alert, historically, we know that the mission comes off. I wonder how much of this actual tension happened in the planning. Like, was there this, like, really tense back and forth as far as what the process was going to be? There, the white M16s.
Fire.
Ooh. Careful, Fred Astaire. Completely missed the target. Missed the backstop, too. Come on.
Any idea where it went?
Nothing I can see.
All right, we're in line for the final run. You ready?
Ready. Whoa.
No hurry, just a straight shot from here, 12 o'clock all the way.
Charles, we'll have to find some more stick time for you later.
Yeah, Roger by himself. Purchased with one person.
We've got to come up with a totally new design for the module's docking system that's not based on either pre-existing system.
This is for history.
Yeah, I mean,
some
it really was.
People will write the history of this time, and they will say America and the Soviet Union put aside their differences and joined together in a symbolic gesture that inspired the world.
Yeah, well, it doesn't seem very safe. I mean, what if that thing explodes in the atmosphere?
See? No fiery radioactive explosion. It's just another day at the office.
Why did you adopt me?
We were going through a rough spot.
After Shane died. So I was your band-aid.
No.
What drew you to the space program?
These guys would be like Army Navy.
I was in Soviet Air Force.
There you go.
Selected for cosmonaut training by a superior officer.
Two? Apollo Soyuz.
No.
There is an order to the toasting. First, to fallen comrades.
Is this KGB sitting here watching them?
I don't know what's going to happen here. And I'm not going to toss my whole life aside for you again. This is an affair.
Yeah.
That's what this is. It doesn't have to be just that. I love you. I couldn't say it 10 years ago, and I lost you, but I'm saying it now.
IMU-2 has shown us 2 kilometers right of our landing path.
Other unit shows zero error. Must be malfunctioning.
Now tell me why I did that.
It's something about the navigation units.
You changed our course to kind of interesting. To compensate for the error.
And?
Yes, that is an amazing pilot.
Bureaucrats, they love their reports. Don't know what they do with them, but they love to get them.
Sounds familiar.
One might even believe Soyuz Apollo is a ruse to obtain Soviet specifications.
Good night.
We have civil defense drills in all our major cities now.
You know, yeah, they probably did.
During the 70s, now they are back.
What do we do about our docking problem? What?
Soyuz.
Apollo.
Trial time, darling.
Well, I have about 30 seconds.
Does he not really like her? I can't tell what the tension is between those two. You know, there are people who think outer space isn't real. Twitter. That's... Would she call the adoption agency? Oh, she shouldn't do that. I feel like it's opening a can of emotional worms that you just shouldn't do.
The first living being to go to outer space.
Can't top that. The lack of.
I hear data from the dog fight informed the selection process for human beings.
Mm-hmm.
Thermal control failed. The capsule overheated. She suffered and died a few hours later.
Is that true? I'm going to look that up.
She went to outer space for the people she loved and for anybody who loved her back.
The universal docking system? I figured I needed some inspiration, so I thought, go to the source.
Engineers who like to get their hands dirty are the best.
Thanks.
He's drunk.
I am not.
That's beautiful.
It really is.
Identical on both sides. There's nothing to disperse the energy of contact. If you hit hard, you could rupture the hull.
Of course. A completely
15 episodes for
androgynous
to a star.
Docking system. Now, leading up to the approach, the two crafts will need to coordinate their approach. So
she's gonna be doing much better this time visiting Deke. Oh, Tracy landed a very rich guy. Kind of surprised Bort is here.
I'm getting Tracy back.
Whoa.
Is that right? Or maybe I'll let you go ahead and try. Because I don't think she's going anywhere, Gordo. But you know what the truth is. She ain't mine, she ain't yours. She's hers.
Last time she was pretty adamant that you had to come out or she wasn't going to.
Living our lives.
Start living our real lives.
He works at Boeing now. He doesn't need this.
He's not getting a divorce. Like my heart stopped for 10 years and then suddenly started beating again.
I think this is beautiful and I think they should get divorced.
Where's our brass band?
Flying him in the middle of the night. No pomp and circumstance, no welcome. Patting him down. Boy, Hollywood does not make living in the Soviet Union fun. I don't know how realistic that is. I mean, the Americans kind of paints the same picture, so I don't know if it's just like a tropes, or if this is just how cold and standoffish the Soviet Union in general was as a country. I mean, obviously, in its form, it doesn't exist anymore, and all we in the States really get is a kind of a Hollywood version of it. But I mean, we know that like economically there were struggles and things like that. There was shortages, and you know, it doesn't seem like the sunniest place. Also, very cold doesn't help. I'm really glad that we didn't just kind of resign Larry and Ellen to being together for the sake of appearances forever. So I'm kind of glad we're kind of breaking away from that. I hope it works out for them. Ellen seems to think that she's going to leave NASA to make this work. I'd be surprised if she did. I don't know in what regard she would. Yeah, like, what do we do with her character if she leaves NASA? I don't think she's leaving the show. So I don't know if she's going to be an out woman, right? She's going to be in the late 1970s or mid 1970s, a gay woman out of the closet, living with another woman, kind of publicly, especially such a recognizable public figure. So how is that going to play? Obviously, when Reagan was president, was later. It was the 80s, but I mean, things weren't great for the gay community in the 80s either. So it's not like in this version of the world that things are suddenly more accepting and better. I mean, things are better for women because we had the Equal Rights Amendment passed and everything. But as far as, you know, Ellen being able to live as an openly gay woman and maintain her security clearance and all that, I do think that there's a problematic, and I don't know how she stays in her position. I don't think that this is how that ends, right? I don't think that she and Larry get divorced and she moves she leaves NASA and lives happily ever after with Pam. I think there's going to be more complicating factors than that. Kind of curious how it's going to work. I mean, Larry's, you know, had boyfriends, even though they sneak in and out. Larry's kind of living his own life, as Ellen pointed out there, by not working for NASA, by working for Boeing. So maybe Ellen can do that. By working for Boeing, Larry's still clearly involved in the space, the space program in his own way. Even talked about it there, right? The asteroid belts, Mars, Jupiter. You know, these are the things we're working on. So I don't know how that's going to shake out. It's nice to see Tracy doing better. That was really awkward, Gordo saying, going to Sam and saying, I'm going to go get my wife back. I don't, like, even though Tracy seems to be, you know, looking back fondly on her time with Gordo, I don't get any sense that that means that she wants to be married to him again, right? That she wants to leave Sam to be with Gordo. You know, yeah, she's on the moon now. She's away from Sam. She's away from her rich life, her celebrity life. So maybe that makes it easier for her to think back on those times when she was just an astronaut. But I don't get the sense that that means she wants to leave Sam for Gordo. And I don't know what I would think about Tracy as a character if she did. I think that would be detrimental. I think you move on. You know, and even if she decided that Sam wasn't right for her, and I don't think she's going to, Sam seems great. I don't see her saying like, well, there's, you know, 3 billion, 4 billion other men in the world. I guess Gordo Stevens is the only way I can go. I'd be really surprised if it ends up there. They may talk about it. She may gently let him down. You know, we have kids together. We're always going to love each other, whatever. But I do not see a scenario when Tracy and Gordo are together. I think this is a miscalculation and a misreading on Gordo's part. And just because that there were happy times when you were married, every married couple had happy times before the marriage was over. That doesn't mean that you go back to it. I think this is a mistake on Gordo's part for taking this step. And you know, honestly, Sam seems so unthreatened by it that I don't even think he's going to like call and warn and go off to Tracy about it. All that, yeah, that SOB excess of yours is on his way. And he says he's going to win you back. I don't think he's even going to do that. I think he's like, yeah, good luck, dude. Yeah, I love Gordo, but I really think he goofed there. In that, I think that was wrong. Especially starting the conversation to Sam. I don't care. It's like, just want it out in the open. That's not noble. I don't think that's noble. I think that's catty. I think that's confrontational. I think it's not designed to be a good person. It's designed to make someone else feel like garbage and yourself to feel better. I don't like that at all. Kind of interesting to see, you know, the tensions. I like the fact that, you know, with the Apollo Soyuz mission, the tensions between the military and between the politicians are still high, but the tension between the scientists just aren't there, right? They're just scientists. I remember watching I think it was Ken Burns documentary, maybe it was Ken Burns, on the American highway system. I know that sounds boring. It was fascinating. And, you know, in like 1940, during World War II, before America was involved, but when the Nazis were very much rolling through Europe, America had so many highway deaths. And so the Army Corps of Engineers went to the Nazi engineers and said, how come you guys have a better highway system than us? Can you show us, please? And they took them to the Autobahn during World War II. And these engineers got together, and the Nazi government really helped America redesign its highway system. You know, old highways like the two-lane things, you know, with a lot of entrances and exits. So there's a lot of accidents, a lot of people dying. And now we have the four-lane highways with a lot of separation and exits only like every mile or so, and really cut down on highway deaths because the science, and the point I'm making is the scientists got the politics out of the way and just focused on science for the sake of doing good for humanity. Boy, I wish there was more of that in the world. And this Apollo Soyuz mission really kind of shows that a little bit. I think it's, and because of that, I think it's still going to go off like it did historically. And I think it is going to be a big deal for the show, of de-escalating tensions. You know, I guess in America, you know, the actual Ronald Reagan, the height of the Cold War, which is in the 80s, there was that made-for-TV movie, the morning after, the day after, right? Which really kind of was a sobering reality check for Americans, what Ronald Reagan's nuclear war that he kept kind of really threatening would look like, and that reality check took a lot of the charm off of it. We're probably not going to get that moment in the 1970s here on this show, but I think Apollo Soyuz is going to help that. And then hopefully that means that people aren't going to be shooting each other with white rifles on the moon. But we shall see. Catch you on the next one, guys.